So this is a video on how to make trout dough bait. I've used it a lot. It's worked great for me. So yeah, let's just get down into it. So the first thing you need is some flour, just, you know, all-purpose flour, some cornmeal, some garlic powder, and some oats. Now we're gonna put a cup of flour into the bowl. Now mind you, this makes a whole lot of dough bait. That's in there. I like to put only about a third of a cup of cornmeal in there, just for the fact that this stuff will make it a little more soft than I like. And then I'm also put in about a third of a cup of oats as well. And then here, add your garlic powder. It's gotta be garlic powder, not garlic salt. That's just, well, my preference, that is. And we'll put 2 tablespoons of that in there. You can put more if you'd like for more scent. It's kind of up to you, but this is just how I make it. Give that a good stir real quick. And then what you're gonna do is just add some water. Don't add too much or else you won't get that dough effect. I like to add it real slow just to make sure I get the right consistency. That's about right. Okay, now what I do, which I've seen quite a few videos on YouTube of people just leaving it like this or freezing it or putting it in the refrigerator or what have you. I like to boil mine. Make it into small balls. Turn that up a little bit. Just make it into a small ball, roll it in your hands. Something like that. Just toss it in there. I usually like to leave them in there for a minute or so, and it's not too bad. Just you got to make sure you boil it long enough to where it'll create like a hard doughy shell around it. Not necessarily hard, but it makes it more pliable when you put it on your hook, whether it's a treble hook or what have you. And I just sit here and just make them. Just throw them in there. This is really the longest part of the process, which isn't bad, but I like to do it just so it stays on the hook better. Because I've made some without boiling it, and it falls off when you cast, or if it's sitting out there for too long. Oh, and you don't want your water up to a very high boil. You want it more like a simmering boil. That's just what I've found works best. So I'll throw quite a bit of it in there and then kind of let it sit for a minute and then take it out and then put it on your napkin here to dry out for about 10 minutes or so. Give it a little stir just so it doesn't stick to the bottom. This will be done here in a second. Apologies for the length of this. It's just, you know, it's what it takes to make it. And I've had great success with this in general. I have several other recipes I have that also work very well. I'll post those a little later. But this is just the more common one I make for myself and a couple of my friends. I mean, I haven't bought certain baits that you can buy in stores in, God, months now that I've learned how to make this. Just because it works that well. Okay, so just take them out. Set them on your paper towel there. Just let them cool while we're making the rest of these. Make sure you get them all out of there. All right. And you pretty much just repeat the process until all your dough bait is made up. We've got to turn that down a little high. Okay. Try to do this quick for you guys so you don't get too terribly bored watching this, because this is literally the longest, most tedious part of it all, obviously, is the boiling part. But I swear by it. I hate it when it's just like this, when it's just in a doughy ball. I can't stand it. It doesn't stick to my hook as well, and it's hard to, as you can see, it's a little difficult to handle unless it's a lot colder or almost frozen. So we'll just keep going with this for now. And while these are boiling, I'll get out some that I have already made up and kind of show you why I like to boil them. And they'll stay good for quite some time in the refrigerator. I don't want to say an exact time, not completely sure, but because I always burn through it before it goes bad, in a sense. And while those are boiling up, I'll grab that out of the refrigerator real quick. I guess I should have been a little more prepared. So this is straight out of the bag. I mean, it's extremely doughy and pliable. You can make it into whatever you want. You can tear it off into smaller pieces. Doesn't stick to your hands. It works very, very well. And it's exactly like a Play-Doh after you boil it. I mean, if you make a comparison from this to this, this doesn't stick at all. And, you know, this does. So it's just my preference. If you don't want to boil it, don't. If you do, I'd strongly recommend it. But like I said, everybody has their own preferences. So that's about done. Just take these out. Same process. One more. Okay, last of it right here. Shit, that's a little high. Yeah, you want to make sure you don't put it in there when it's boiling hot like that. Just a simmer works well. I mean, you can make some balls bigger, some smaller, whatever you're fishing for. Oh, and you know, another thing, this with the garlic in it as well, it works fairly good for catfish as well. I mean, I've seen a lot of videos on YouTube as well of using garlic or cheese and whatnot for catfish bait. But I like to do a lot of trout fishing. The catfish up at the lakes around here just aren't worthwhile, so to speak. And after this video, I'll be posting some other videos on some other recipes that I like I said in the beginning, that work pretty damn good. This is just the quick and easy setup that I like to use more times than none. Just boil up for just a minute. But yeah, generally this recipe will make about double that. I made this 3 days ago, and it was about up to here. It's full. And I went out, did a little bit of night fishing, and needless to say, I used quite a bit, caught quite a few. Yeah, you want to make sure you stir them. Like I said, just some of them are sticking to the bottom and you don't want them to burn. And see, now that these are out, they're much more doughy, much more pliable, and it just makes it a whole hell of a lot easier to handle, you know, when you're out there and it's not sticking to your fingers or anything. Just makes it real simple. You know, tear a ball in half, put it on your hook, and you're good. Rather than having to wash your hands all the time or anything like that. So these are about done. Set that out of the way. Alright, and all you got to do is wait for them to cool down. Like I said, give them about 10-15 minutes or so. Let them dry off, and they pretty much turn into a very, very pliable dough. I mean, it's pretty much like a Play-Doh, and you can shape it into a grub. I mean, what have you, whatever, you know, whatever your heart desires. It just makes things a lot easier. Yeah, that's about it. I place them in a bag. I usually label what I have on them. Obviously, you know, I already put the other bag away, but I'll label what's in it just so you know what's working, what may not be working that day. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video, and let me know how it works for you. Thanks for watching.